When starting your game as Zane, you only got three choices to make. Which action skill, skill tree, and playstyle are you gonna like the most? Yo, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another Borderlands 3 video. In today's video, we're gonna be going over the Zane leveling guide. Basically, this leveling guide is pretty simple. In my opinion, any skill tree is viable to level with during your first playthrough. So whichever one you wanna go with and experiment with, that's what you should use. So we're gonna break down each one. Before we get into it, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel for more Borderlands 3 content. Don't forget to join the Zane Nation Discord channel, link will be in a pinned comment down below. And if you want to hit that notification bell to get notified when I post, go ahead and do that for me. Thanks. So first, before we get into it, let's put some timestamps up on the screen while I read you the disclaimer. Now, you can skip to each section. Like I said, it's just going to be set up for each skill tree. Now, the only other thing to keep in mind is this guide is for the base game only. Now, if you haven't gotten into the game yet, basically Zane has one very good class mod called See Undead, and it's from the DLC. So if you want to just get through the game as easy as possible, you should just go over to the Moxie's Handsome Jackpot DLC, get a See Undead mod, and then finish the playthrough. But otherwise, if you don't have the DLC or you just want to play the base game first, then this is the guide for that. So let's hop straight into it. First, we're going to talk about the Hitman tree. Basically, for levels 1 through 5, you want Violent Momentum. This is your only pure weapon damage skill in the skill tree, and this skill is very strong. It basically carries this entire tree. And yeah, this is your base for everything you do. So for the next 5 levels, we're going to put 3 into Violent Speed and 2 in Salvation. So for the next 5 levels, we need Death Follows Close, and then we're going to get 2 more into Violent Speed, topping it off, and 1 last point into Salvation. Giving us 3 out of 5 total for the lower levels is, it feels good enough for me. And finally, we're going to toss 1 point into Cool Hand. So for 16 through 20, now I suggest putting a point into Drone Delivery. Early on, there's not super good grenades, but if you find a Tracking Grenade or the Whispering Ice Grenade, I believe it's called, you get throughout the playthrough. It's a grenade that you can get for completing a story mission. That one's really good with Drone Delivery. Otherwise, we're going to stick 2 points into Cool Hand and then 2 more points into Violent Violence. This gets our DPS skills, our fast reload speed and fire rate, and this stuff's great. So for the last 5 levels before the capstone, 20 to 25, we're going to stick 3 points into Good Misfortune, our last point into Violent Violence, and then we're going to top off with 4 out of 5 Salvation, our last point into Salvation, for when we're starting to get at this higher level of the story. And finally, we stick that last point into See in Red. So this is the Hitman skill tree up to See in Red. This is how I would do it. This is how I was playing in some of this footage. The Hitman skill tree is probably Zane's best damaging skill tree. Of course, you can do some cool stuff with the Red tree, but it's mainly Violent Momentum and also Playing Dirty. Now, the reason why I didn't suggest Playing Dirty for the leveling guide and the leveling playthrough is because you don't really choose what guns you get early on. You can definitely use Playing Dirty. This is one of Zane's best skills. I think for leveling, you might want to stay away from this skill, but it is a very good skill. Now keep in mind for the drone, while leveling, Boomsday is a very good augment. The rockets, because the drone can actually do good damage while leveling, so the rockets will actually get more kills. Otherwise, the two best augments for the drone are Bad Dose and Static Field. Now, I highly suggest looking for an Infiltrator class mod with the Hitman tree, and then you don't want to use Static Field, but Bad Dose is pretty decent. You could even run Static Field and Boomsday if you want on some of these builds. But those are the three augments I'd look at while leveling, and then Boomsday definitely falls off in Mayhem 4, and yeah. So next, I have 2 different builds for you, depending if you want to play the Barrier or the Clone. So let's go over the Drone Barrier build real quick. Basically, this is your pick up your barrier and go. Stay undercover, get kills back to back, keep your action skills up using Good Misfortune, and when they go down, you want to use quick recharging shields with this build and the skill Adrenaline. Basically, that's going to help you get your action skills back, and you can use See in Red over and over again. Now, you can also use the Clone and the Barrier with this build because they both have the shortest cooldowns. Basically, you would just want to get a point into Fractal Frags and Quick Breather. Probably from Borrowed Time. But yeah, you can also switch between your action skills in this build. You can pull out the clone whenever you want. So this is this version of that build. And then next we have the clone and the drone. Now this is focusing on our clone and our drone to do damage along with us. basically we got all the way into Boom Enhance to turn our clone into a badass clone. And while leveling and through the story, like if you play the story and then you play True Vault Hunter mode, this build is going to be really fun. Even through a lot of Mayhem levels while you're leveling up to Mayhem 4, this build is still going to be really fun. It's going to work for you. Honestly, in the background, I'm playing the Hitman tree, and I'm kind of leveling towards this build because this is just a very fun playstyle, in my opinion. So now let's get into the Double Agent tree. If you want to use this one while leveling, it's super fun. This is kind of your soldier type of class for Zane. You get damage, you get some healing. Your clone is really fun to play with. In my opinion, it's Zane's best designed action skill. In the endgame, it's not always the best, but it does some really cool tricks with shields. Once you finally get into double barrel, there are some insane utility and some cool things you can give the clone. So this is a tree I actually like a lot, and this is how I would level it. For the first five levels, just go synchronicity. It's a bunch of free damage. For our next five levels, we're picking up Donnybrook. Now, if you could get Donnybrook first, I would suggest it. This is the best early game skill, in my opinion. Once again, it's damage, and then second of all, it's health regen. Both of those things are going to help you out in the early game. This is kind of your healing along with another skill we're going to talk about. For the next five levels, I would pick up Quick Breather, Fractal Frags, and then Borrowed Time. Quick Breather and Fractal Frags are going to be insane for your clone. Now, Fractal Frags might not be super useful until you find a good grenade mod. The clone doesn't always throw grenades perfectly, but it's what gives the personality to your clone. And Quick Breather is a very good survivability skill. Early on, you don't need to worry so much about health gating, so getting your shield full by swapping with your clone is going to do a lot of work for you. These next five levels are really good for us. We get to get Old You. This skill is basically the best survivability this tree has to offer, especially once we get to Boom Enhance. Our clone is going to be super powerful, and if we pair this with the correct shields, like stopgap shields, this is always going to get you back up. So after that, we went 3 in Supersonic Man. This is just a good skill, and it's going to get us some damage later. And finally, stick that last point into Praemunitus. This gets us to our last 5 skill points before the capstone. We get to get Boom Enhance, and then stick a couple points into Pocket Full of Grenades. When our clone dies, we'll be able to keep up the grenade count. And then get the last 2 points of Praemunitus, just a little bit more mag size, rounding you off, getting you ready for Double Barrel. Now, this is the capstone of the clone tree, and this is a very fun capstone. Early on, looking for guns to do damage, I would say the Skexel, Dahl Assault Rifles, one-shot reload, like Jacobs shotguns, like stagecoaches, COV rocket launchers. Give him any rocket launcher or any type of explosive weapon if you can, just to see if he does good with it. He doesn't do good with everything, but he does do well with the right rocket launchers. And then you can always give him a face puncher and use melee artifacts. The double barrel skill offers some insane utility. It's extremely fun, but it can be frustrating because there are a number of things that don't work. But there's definitely some things that do work, and this skill, this capstone, this tree is really fun in my opinion. Now, the best augments for this tree are, by far, Doppelbanger is going to be the best one in the endgame. It can do some damage, and it's pretty good early on as well. This is usually used for activating action skill and anointments. But besides that, I like Schadenfreude a lot, and Which One Is Real. I think these are the two best augments for leveling anyway. Once again, Schadenfreude will give you shield back, along with Quick Breather. You can keep your shields up really well with a clone playstyle. And Which One Is Real will take that aggro off of you. Your clone won't do bad at getting kills. I highly suggest looking for Nova Shields if you're going to play the clone. You can actually farm a Nova Burner from the Power Troopers, which is right before the Katagawa Jr. fight. That is in Promethea. It's pretty early on you can farm for that shield. And that shield carried me past Grave Ward. I'm still using it right now. I got it at a pretty low level. So I highly suggest looking for Nova Shields. The other one is the Frozen Heart Shield. You can get it for killing an ice boss later on. I don't want to spoil anything if you are new to the series, but you're going to know exactly who I'm talking about. So for level 53, depending if you want to play the drone or the barrier, we have 2 builds for you. So the clone drone build is basically like the drone clone build we went over earlier, just with the capstones mismatched. Basically, if you want to play more focused on the clone, then you can, but the C and red capstone is also very good. So it's really just preference what you want to do. Basically, with this build, it's kind of the same playstyle as that build, but your clone will do a lot of damage for you early on. I highly suggest looking for rocket launchers to give to your clone. The COV Shreddas and Chukkas, I think, are the best options, but if you can find any, like, alien barrels, give them a ton of stuff. Usually rocket launchers will do the most damage, though. Just my suggestion. Keep in mind he doesn't work with everything. It seems like he has a dull assault rifle before you unlock double barrel, and that's what he shoots the best sometimes. But RPGs are by far some of the most damage you can get out of him in the end game as well. So keep that in mind. And for our second build, we have Clone Barrier. This is basically Calm, Cool, and Collected plus Double Barrel. Basically what this does is it allows you to get an infinite clone if he can stay alive. Now you can do this pretty easily, like I said, with the Frozen Heart shields. I highly suggest looking farming for the Skexel. I believe it's from Skrak, but just look it up. It's called the Skexel. It's a COV pistol. The clone shoots this very well. He'll freeze enemies with brain freeze. There's other good weapons like this. He's really good with burst fire weapons in this build. Finally, let's go into the undercover tree. Now, this tree is actually probably Zane's best tree in the base game. Now, the blue tree offers the most damage possible. The red tree is probably the funnest in the middle ground tree. But this tree is super defensive. It basically makes you unkillable once you're like done leveling in the base game, as long as you can play well. But it doesn't offer any damage at all. Let's cover which skills I'd level first. Now, for skills 1 through 5, I would get Adrenaline. Now, for the next 5 levels, I would use Brain Freeze. Brain Freeze paired with multi-pellet weapons will freeze so many enemies, like, so easily. This freezes enemies faster than any cryo weapons ever could. And yeah, this was considered one of, like, Zane's... Some people argued this was Zane's best skill. And it's definitely in his top 5 in the base game, for sure. Brain Freeze is an insane skill. So get this as soon as possible. Now, for levels 11 to 15, we gotta put that point into Confident Competence. And next, I think we want to get 4 points into Rise to the Occasion. This will basically, this is the health regen from this tree. I think it's important for leveling. Next, from 16 to 20, we want to get Really Expensive Jacket. This is a really good skill. And then toss that last point into Rise to the Occasion. And then you can put your last 3 points into Ready for Action. Ready for Action is also an insanely good skill. We're actually going to be using 5 in Ready for Action by the end game. So keep in mind how we had 5 in Adrenaline. That's because Adrenaline is a really good leveling skill. But in the end game, Ready for Action is much better. And then finally, we have the last point into Calm, Cool, and Collected. Don't forget 1 point into Refreshments as well. Now, this is the true capstone of this tree. There's pretty much no point while leveling to get the actual capstone because it's pretty niche and like pretty specific with whatever shield you find. It's really good with the stopgap and it's really good with booster shields. So now let's get into the level 53 builds once you've gotten Calm, Cool, Collected. The first one is called Calm, Cool, and Explosions. Now this one is actually Rainbow Slushy. It's a build posted on my channel. Basically, this is a really good build, honestly. Basically, what you do is you use the clone plus Doppelbanger to activate all your action skill and anointments. And then you have Calm, Cool, Collected, and you freeze an enemy, and the clone comes right back. So basically, you can just loop Doppelbanger over and over again. I could actually imagine this being cool while leveling by literally just exploding enemies with your clone over and over again. It could be cool. It could be good. And then pair that with your clone with a Nova Shield. This definitely could be really good while leveling. And next, for our other build, you heard me talk about this earlier, but this is Stopgap CCC. Now, I also have a build guide for this. This is actually the Calm, Cool, Collected build I basically recommend. Now, I do have an updated level 53 version as well. But anyways, Calm, Cool, Collected, Stopgap, and Distributed Denial is a really strong interaction. It's a really strong combo. Basically, every time your barrier goes down, you get 5 seconds of immunity. So you're basically, well, you're not basically invincible, but you're almost invincible while your barrier is up. And when it happens to go down, you get 5 seconds of immunity, which you can freeze an enemy in that 5 seconds and get your barrier right back. So this also creates a pretty strong loop, and it's a really good build. So anyways, guys, that is really it for the leveling guide. I broke down each skill tree and how I would level them, and then I gave you guys a bunch of builds to go with each of them. Now, like I said, this video was going to be very long, But that's because every skill tree is fine for leveling, in my opinion. You just need to know which skills are the best and like which ones to get first. Anytime I build a level 53 build right now, it's almost just using these skill trees. Because like I said, these are all the best skills for general play. Now, keep in mind there are some niche skills, like Cold Boar even. I talked about playing Dirty earlier, how we're not using it for leveling. It's because it's kind of gun dependent in a way, and I kind of just don't, like, I feel like while leveling, it's not necessary. That is one of Zane's best skills by far in the end game. That's a completely different thing from leveling, in my opinion, is the end game. So definitely experiment, definitely play around with whatever skills you want, because you might find a crazy interaction that is a whole end game build. A really good example of that is Stopgap Distributed Denial. That is one of the end game builds I recommend. However, during leveling, I would never tell you to get Distributed Denial. You know what I mean? But anyways, guys, that is it for the video. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, drop a like on it and subscribe to the channel if you want to see more. Join the Zane Nation Discord. Link will be in a pinned comment down below. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this and this helped you out. I'll see you guys in the next one. I'm out.